Onboarding new employees or new team members can be a very arduous process, and there are a lot of details that can get dropped, frankly. But it doesn't have to be complicated. In this video, I want to show you how to use no-code tools to simplify and streamline your onboarding process. We're going to be going into a template that has been provided by Fillout to assist us with the onboarding process. We're going to include workflows so that we can approve or reject applications as they come in, and we will also include scheduling so that we can further onboard employees as they join the team. If learning more about how to streamline your HR and onboarding experience is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you escape spreadsheets and embrace the power of no-code tools. And in this video, I'm going to be showcasing how you can use one of our favorite no-code tools, Fillout, to simplify and streamline your onboarding process. But before we get into that, I first want to invite you to join me to grab some templates. These templates that we built for you here at Gap Consulting are going to take five of the most common use cases that we see in no code and get you up and running in them quickly. Things like payment processing, sending out invoices, project management, you name it. You can grab our free templates with video tutorials at gapconsulting.io/templates. Now, without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen. I'm here inside of Fillout. If you are already a Fillout user, feel free to follow along with me. And if you're not, consider signing up for Fillout using our affiliate link, which I will share here with this video. It's a great way for you to show some love back to the channel. So here inside of Fillout, there are a ton of different templates to access, and you can get there simply by clicking up here to templates. If you see a particular category, you can go right there. In our case, I'm going to head over to all templates. And here inside of role, I'm going to open this up and go to HR. So inside of human resources, where there's a bunch of different templates that we could use, I'm going to scroll down here and take a look at the employee onboarding form template. Now, this is great, right? We get a demo on what this template is, what this form is all about. And when we're ready, we can opt to use the template. So here it is. This is what it looks like. We can cycle through the different pages. We're asking the employee, the new person who's getting onboarded, for their information. We're also able to then ask them for the emergency contact. We can then go through some different options like training and development plan is either on the job or online. So you can see how they're passing through different departments here as they're getting onboarded in terms of training, in terms of HR. You know, there's a lot of different pieces of information we have to collect when we onboard someone, and putting together a form like this, integrating it with no code, is going to simplify that process. Now here we can go down, we're asking them for feedback, of course. We also have their job title, salary, and all this other information. So this is a great place for you to make sure that you have all of their information up to date when you bring them on board. And then lastly, we're going to go through some company policies and procedures. And this is great because we can link directly to the different components that we want them to check off. So they're going to acknowledge that they received the employee handbook, code of conduct and ethics, all of those key components to onboarding a new team member. Once they're done, then they go to the final page and that's it. It's all good. So how easy is it to use this form template? Well, all we have to do is say use template and we get right into it. So that is pretty darn simple, right? So here it is, my brand new employee onboarding form. You'll notice this is called template 7, so I can rename this if I'd like. And I don't have to, but I can continue from here. Now, Fillout forms are very easy to edit and update. So if you have certain questions that aren't quite aligned with this template, of course, I encourage you to make this your own. So down here at the bottom, we have all of the different pages of the template. Personal information is pretty straightforward, so I won't imagine that there are any edits here. But maybe on the employment information page, we don't want to ask for salary. It's so easy to remove this. Just highlight the field and click delete. It's now gone. In addition, we can bring other fields in. So these are the different types of fields here on the side. We can easily drop them in. So if we had a new drop-down question like, what's your favorite food? Style, or cuisine, then, you know, we can edit some options here. In order to edit different drop-down options, we can open up this right-hand panel and edit option one and option two. We could bring in things like Italian food, Chinese food, etc. We can reorder these things very simply, and it's that easy to put together a form. So once we're done with any edits, we simply come up here to publish, and we also have the opportunity to preview that form and actually walk through it to make sure that it functions and looks the way we expect it to. Now, one of my favorite things that we can do with Fillout is actually integrate it with a backend database. We can do this with multiple different data sources. In this video, let's take a look at using Airtable as the backend. So imagine that we had a table here where we said we want to map information as it's filled out in Fillout. We want to send it here to Airtable. So maybe we are looking at stuff like the employee information. Here I am in a brand new database, and I'm going to delete the superfluous fields that are created when we first start a new database. And I will map out the fields in the fill out form over to my database. So here we have full name, phone number, and email. Let's go into Airtable and set that up. So I'll make this field the full name field. And of course, that's going to be text, right? We're receiving a text input, so I'll keep it this way. The phone number, let's map it here. And that will be a phone number field type in Airtable, because obviously we're collecting a phone number. And then lastly, we will have email here, and that will be an email field type. So it's very, very simple to integrate Fillout with your backend database. Now that we built the structure in the database, let's head back over to Fillout. We will exit the preview here, and we will go to the integrate component. So here we can choose the different popular apps. You can see there are many different options here, things like Google Sheets, Smart Suite, etc. We're going to select Airtable here. We will then choose the account that we want to link to. Now, we build with Airtable all the time, so we have multiple setups here. But let me go ahead and connect a new account. Fairly simple here. This will be just mapped as demo, and I will connect to Airtable. Now on this screen, I have to tell it which database or databases I want to give it access to. And I named ours Onboarding with Fillout. So let's find it here. And just that easy, I will grant access there. So now this particular Fillout form is integrating with our database called Onboarding with Fillout, the one we were just building. And it's going to say, you know, tell us the table that you want to sync responses to. So we will say, hey, we only have this one database here to connect to. And of course, we only have one table that we did not rename. It's just called table one. And just like that, we can decide, are we going to create new records or are we going to update existing records in Airtable when the form is submitted? So in our case, we'll say create new records. And now we'll go on to the mapping component. So we can map what records are going where. So we'll say, hey, in Airtable, we've got these three different fields, email, full name, and phone number. So we simply map each one of these to the form field in Fillout. So here we'll say in our Fillout form, we ask for email. Let's map to that. Here we have the Airtable field full name, and we ask for that. And here, lastly, we have the phone number in Airtable, and we ask for it here in the Fillout form under personal information as well. So it's really that easy. We've mapped these fields. So now when we receive a new submission to the form, it will automatically create a new record in Airtable with the information that we just mapped. This update is real time. So as soon as that submission is received in Fillout, it's going to be reflected immediately in Airtable as well. Now, Fillout is not just about collecting data. We can also build workflows inside of the tool. So let's take a look at what would happen if we receive a form submission. Well, we might want to audit it. We want to take a look in our HR department and make sure that we received all the information that we expected to receive. So how do we build a workflow? Well, here inside of the form, I'm still in Fillout, employee onboarding here, and I'm on the integrate page, I can click on workflows. And this is where we can use either a templated workflow or build a blank workflow from scratch. Now for us, we want to build a workflow where when the form is received, we will submit it for approval in Slack. So we can start up with an approval workflow here. Let's go with the approval approve or reject. So we'll start with this. You can see that the workflow is mapped out here. We'll create this workflow, and now we have the ability to edit it. So maybe we don't want it to say approve or reject. We want to check to see, is it complete or incomplete? So we can edit this, right? We'll just go into here, edit on this approval step, and we will change these options to be complete or incomplete. Fairly simple. We can also choose how the approval is going to go. So are we receiving the approval request in email, a Slack DM, or a Slack channel? In our case, let's do a Slack DM. I'll connect to Slack here, and I will just send this message directly to me inside of Slack. And you could imagine that it's doing this in a channel for HR, or alternatively sending it specifically to one user in your Slack account. Once we connect our Slack account, we can then choose who the approver is because I've chosen the direct message option, and I'll make sure to select myself here from the Slack account, but I have access to all of the other people on this Slack account. Now, also note that we can further customize this. We can change what the approver input is. So if we want to add some input options in terms of short text, checkbox, dropdown, etc., we can do that here. And then we also have the Slack message. So I could add a message, edit the message. This is an edited message, for example. We can also choose whether or not to include the full submission by simply toggling on or off this button. And then this is now good. Now, after this, what happens if it is complete, marked complete? Well, then this is the action that is taken. Maybe what we want to do is send an email to the person who filled out the form, and we want to invite them to schedule a one-on-one with their boss or the CEO of the company. That's one option, and we can build that out in just a moment. The other side of it is, what happens if it's marked incomplete? What are we gonna do? Well, in this case, we might send a different email that says something like, hey, sorry, your submission was rejected. Please fill out the form again. You get the idea here. This is fully customizable to whatever your needs are. But let's talk a little bit more about the approval process, and then I want to walk through a live example from start to finish so we can see how this whole thing comes together. So let's imagine that we want to send a link to a calendar. Well, it just so happens that I've already built a form inside of Fillout that uses the scheduler option, so let's take a quick look at that. Here we are inside of my personal schedule form. This integrates beautifully with Google Calendar, and there is no additional cost to your Fillout subscription in order to use the calendar function. So the scheduler allows you, much like a Calendly, to integrate with your native calendar. You can see that I've decided the meeting location is Zoom. I can control the duration of this, and people are now able, when I share this URL, to simply book with me directly here. So this is a separate form that I actively use on a regular basis. Let's imagine, though, that we added it here to the email process. So I said, your submission has been approved. Please schedule a call with me here. Now we can highlight this and include a hyperlink, and I'll bring in my calendar link. And just like that, we're all set. And now I can say done. Now from here, I can publish this workflow. That's a good step. And of course, we need to go back and actually publish the live version of the form as well. If you haven't done this, it's going to be very hard to test it out. Now that we're done here, let's take a look at this thing from start to finish to see how it all comes together. Right here, we have the form link, and we can open it up in a new page. This is a live version of the form that we just built. Let me click start here. I'll fill out information in the form really quickly, and we can move on to the approval process. Now, as soon as that form is submitted, we get the notification in Slack. So let's go ahead and pop Slack up. You'll see I just received a direct message. It came only to me, and it was sent from Fillout. So I can review the information that came in, look over that, and then mark it as complete. This is going to open up the actual record in Fillout, and it's asking me to confirm this submission. Please review the submission. You'll see that complete is right here. It's not yet marked complete. I have to actually push this button, but this is where all of the submissions will be stored in addition to being stored in Airtable as well. So all I have to do is mark it complete here, and then that will trigger the next step of the workflow, which is to send out the email with the calendar link in it. Let's pop into email to see if we received that. And sure enough, we did. This email is open and it's saying your submission was approved. Schedule a call here. Now this person can click on that link and get access directly to a calendar, take the next steps, put their information in. We can even pre-fill this information if we include it in the URL in our form. The possibilities are endless here, but I hope you can see how much we've streamlined this process and we're not losing any information. Nothing is slipping through the cracks because we have full control from start to finish. I know we went quickly in this video, but any questions we did not address, swing by our website and get some extra help or drop some comments below. Of course, if you receive value here, give us a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, but most importantly, keep on building.